I think there was one talk about it which I missed actually.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to know anything and everything about this. A beginner should know.
Yeah, that's a good point. Okay.
That's all his mindset.
Okay. Anybody else with some expectations? Because there's no expectation, it's much more easier for me because there's nothing to meet for. Yes.
I would say photography is. I would like to take photography as a serious hobby, so I'm just expecting at the end of the session to make time. That's not my expectation.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Anybody else? Young crowd, or maybe people who are been in the industry for a long time, who opted for photography as a stress buster. If you've already been there for a long time, yes, you are not a beginner anymore. But maybe some topics which I would be discussing here would be more of some sophisticated features which are available in the current era. Talking about some latest models, and also a few topics to be touched upon on the basics of photography. Let's say I'm going to start off holding a camera today. So what is that I have to look out for? Or what is that I have to understand before buying a camera? What are the parameters which I'll have to consider before shelling out a few thousands to any brand, be it Canon, Nikon, Sony, Olympus, Fuji, or ABC? Before doing that, what is that you'll have to understand and tell yourself, yes, this is what I should look for on a camera, and this is what it is. I don't want anything more than this. Now, how many of you actually believe that having a good camera could actually create great pictures? One, two, from 30 of them? 30 odd? Yeah, so according to you guys and girls, you feel like yes, having a good camera could create great pictures. But is it true? No, if everything is to be done by the camera, then what do you do as a photographer then? Exactly. I'm coming there. I'm coming there. We're talking about 21st century. Today's camera are no more bad. In fact, good is just a benchmark. Today, you go to any kind of a store, any brand, and ask them for a 3-megapixel or a 6-megapixel or 8-megapixel camera. Then today, the benchline has come up to 10 megapixels. So even if you don't want, the camera will do a good job for you. But again, giving all the credits to the camera is not all that you're here for. Let's say, for example, you want to capture some moments. Yes, buying a point and shoot camera and putting them on auto mode and going tuck, 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 tuck. Is there. That's just going to document certain things. You have to learn how to catalog them. Or create candid stories from those photographs. You're going for a trip. Let's say you're going for a team outing. Then taking your friends, eating or jumping around or playing, singing, dancing, landscape. How do you build a story? From what time or from what stage of your trip do you start photographing? You'll have to stitch the story. How you began. Or this is how we started, this is how it was. This is the first place. You have to stitch the story completely and take it to the end. So that you'll have to start clicking, and one worst aspect of taking photography as a hobby is you wouldn't be in most of the photographs. So if you plan to go back and show it to your friends and family, so make sure at least in a couple of them you give it to your friend and ask them to click a few snaps of yours. Okay? How many of us have actually gone into a different mode other than an auto or a program mode? Yes, one. Okay, let me hear from you, man. What are the modes that you have gone into? Okay.
That's what I know. I mean, I'm a very new person. I mean, I have no idea about it.
Okay.
A few modes that I've used is the one is sports mode and light mode,
okay. Okay, amongst these modes, which is the mode that you have used more often? Which mode? Apart from auto and program mode,
yeah.
Amongst these modes which you have told?
Portrait I have used sometimes.
Okay.
And then sport I have used.
Okay. Okay, now let's say you want to use a portrait mode and switch to a sports mode. So what is the reason behind switching it from an auto mode to either a portrait mode or a sports mode?
Hello.
When I take the picture,
okay.
Somebody is actually posing it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you are in the car and you want to take a picture of from a moving car, for instance,
okay.
Then you generate a
okay, so you're talking about going for a sports mode when there is a motion involved.
Yeah.
Okay. Now that motion could either be from the camera side or at the subject side. Either of which would be accounted for. And a sports mode is actually going to freeze something in action. It need not be only somebody playing something. It could be anything in motion. Somebody going across, walking, running, jogging, your kids playing around, anything. And apart from this, let's say portrait mode. So where do we go to portrait mode? Is it that if you switch to portrait mode, a person will look more beautiful in that? What's happening? What is the camera doing for you? Which the auto mode is not doing, or your sports mode is not doing, or landscape mode is not doing. What is it the portrait mode is doing for you? Does it out of Who was it? Shutter speed, okay. What's the shutter speed?
How fast are you moving?
Okay, so how does that affect your portrait?
If you are exposed for a longer time, for a shorter time, exposed for a shorter time, the image will be blank.
The image will be?
Blank. Longer time, if you are using for a longer time,
okay.
You will be exposed to more light.
Yes.
So you get a very light image.
Yes, okay.
Or if you are going for a
okay.
It would be a black, almost like a black.
Okay. Yeah. So how is that black and white going to affect a portrait?
We say that the exposure of the image.
No, see that is common. It is not going to be a portrait. For landscape, for macro, anything it applies. Now the shutter speed applies to everybody. Or for any kind of a mode you're going to shoot, any subject you're going to shoot. The darkness and brightness is always there. Which is a part of almost all the modes. When you press the shutter has to click.
Yeah, but the duration of the exposure is what matters.
In that case, maybe if you are told that for a sports mode, I would agree. Clicking it on a fast shutter speed would give you a better still image.
And as well as it applies for the amount of light entering through the retina.
Yes, that is what a shutter does. That is a part of almost all the photographs that you click. What is so special about portrait mode? Pardon? Okay, point noted. Very close, yes. Yes. Now the reason for you to go for a portrait, going for portrait mode is mainly to emphasize on the particular person, be it a single portrait or a group. What does it do? Something very close, it tries to bring the subject in front of you. Okay? That's the part of the aperture. Okay? But apart from that, it emphasizes on rich skin tones. Okay? But not all point and shoots could give you an open aperture.